Hello students, in the today's experiment we are going to determine the alkinity of a given sample solution due to the presence of carbonate and hydroxyl ion with the help of N/10 HCl by using phenolphthalein and methylorin indicators. Okay, first of all we talk about what do you mean by the alkinity. The mean of alkinity is the strength or the concentration of alkene. The given sample solution is alkene due to the presence of carbonate and hydroxyl ions. It means we have to determine the concentration of carbonate and hydroxyl ions separately, and for the same we require two indicators. We require the two indicator in this titration. One is phenolphthalein and second one is methylorin. We need two indicators because in this we have to determine the concentration of two ions, carbonate and hydroxyl ions, separately. Whenever we have to determine the strength or the concentration of a given sample solution, then we have to go for the titration. And for the titration, basically we require three things. First is unknown, second is known, and third one is indicator. Unknown is a given sample solution, that is a alkali solution. The alkali solution is basic in nature. Basically the alkali means the water soluble bases are called alkali, and that is be a unknown sample solution. Second one is known solution. Known is a solution which react in a variable manner with the unknown solution, that is N/10 HCl in this case. The third one is indicator. Indicator is a chemical compound which shows the endpoint or the completion of the reaction by changing its own color, and that is be a phenolphthalein and methylorin in this case. Okay, so the complete object of the today's experiment is to determine the alkinity due to the presence of carbonate and hydroxyl ions with the help of N/10 HCl by using phenolphthalein and methylorin two indicators. Okay, now we talk about the theory or the principal part of the experiment. First of all, the given alkaline water sample solution is titrated against N/10 HCl solution in the presence of phenolphthalein indicator. We first use the phenolphthalein indicator in the titration because the phenolphthalein indicator works at a strong basic region or at a high pH value range. So during this, the hydroxyl ions neutralizes completely and the carbonate ions are converted into bicarbonate ions. At this point, the pink color of alkaline solution disappears. In the same solution, the methyl orange indicator is added for bicarbonate ions. Now N/10 HCl, which is a standard solution, is added to neutralize the bicarbonate ions. The endpoint occurs when the sample solution color changes from light yellow to the wine red or a red color. Okay, now we are going to perform the experiment. First of all, we have to fill the burette. See, this is the burette, that is of 50 ml, which we have to fill by the standard solution. And that is here N/10 HCl in this case. We fill the burette with the help of funnel. Remove funnel when you are setting the lower meniscus of the standard solution at 0. Now the lower meniscus of the liquid is set at 0. And the burette is completely filled with the standard solution at mark 0. Now we have to take the unknown sample solution into a conical flask with the help of pipette. See, this is the pipette, and we take the 10 ml of given sample solution, that is alkaline water, due to the presence of hydroxyl and carbonate ions in the conical flask. We already have this 10 ml of unknown sample solution in our conical flask. Now, before starting titration, we have to add the indicator in this. First, we add this phenolphthalein indicator in the given sample solution which contains the carbonate and hydroxyl ion. Why we are using phenolphthalein indicator first? We are using phenolphthalein indicator first because the phenolphthalein indicator works on a high pH range or at a high pH value. As we add this phenolphthalein into the conical flask, the pink color appears. The pink color shows that phenolphthalein is in a basic region. Okay, and as we start our titration, as we start to add the N-10-HCl in the conical flask, which have the carbonate and the hydroxyl ion, see this reaction is going to take place. The reaction is this. The reaction is the hydroxyl ion after getting a positive ion gets completely utilized, whereas the carbonate ions after getting the H positive converted into the bicarbonate ions. See, this is the reaction, these two reactions on which the phenoxylation indicator works. Okay, and during this, whatever amount of HCl is consumed, that is say XML. Okay, but in lieu of XML, we put the reading which we get during the titration. Okay, now we start our titration. We have to add the standard solution into a unknown solution in a dropwise manner. And the end point occurs when the pink color disappears. So this is the end point for the phenoxylation indicator, and during this the hydroxyl ions gets completely utilized, whereas the carbonate ions get partially utilized, they convert into the bicarbonate. And during this, say XML N-10-HCl is consumed, but we put the reading from the butane. That is, that is 6.8 ml. Now we have to put the reading in the observation table. See, this is the observation table. Volume of sample solution is 10 ml. Initial is 0, and the final for the phenoxylation indicator is 6.8 ml. Okay, which is say XML. Okay, now this solution contain the bicarbonate ion, and to neutralize the bicarbonate ion, we have to titrate in continuation. And for the same, we have to add another indicator in this, that is VM methyl orange. So as we add 2 drops of methyl orange indicator in this, a light yellow color is there. Now we have to add the N-10-HCl in this till a wine red or a red color is appear. Is with there. This red or your wine red color is there. This is the end point for the bicarbonate ion or for the methyl orange indicator. So this is the bicarbonate ion which you get from the carbonate ion. It requires a H positive to become completely neutralized, that is H2+0. And for the complete titration, the volume which is required, that is VM. Say y dash ml, but we put the actual reading from the butane, that is here 10.8 ml, and the initial for the methyl orange is 6.8 ml, because we start our titration in continuation. Now what we have to do? We have to do the same job 3 times to get the concordant reading, and we do the same job 3 times and we get the concordant reading, that is 8 ml for the carbonate ions and 2.8 ml for the hydroxyl ion. Now a question arises, why we do this 2 times of y for the carbonate ions in the observation table? See, this is the initial reading of the unit is 0 ml, and reading for the phenoxylation indicator is XML N-10-HCl used against the phenoxylation indicator for the hydroxyl. carboxyl ion and for the carbonyl ion. During this, XML is consumed. So, initial reading portal current is 0 and final portal current is X. Okay? And in continuation, we titrate it with the methyl ion indicator. And the total reading for the HCl is Y dash M. Means that total HCl consumed for hydroxyl and for carbonate ion is Y dash M. So, what is the net volume which is being used only for the bicarbonate ion? That is, this is a Y dash for both of the ions, complete utilization of both of the ions of carbonate and hydroxyl. And this is basically for the hydroxyl and carbonate, partially utilization of the carbonate ion, that is X. So, for the bicarbonate ion is Y dash minus X. So that is called a capital Y. Capital Y is equal to Y dash minus X ml. So this capital Y is exactly the net volume which we use for a bicarbonate ion. Okay. This Y ml N by 10 HCl is used exactly for a bicarbonate. We get this bicarbonate from there. We get this bicarbonate from the carbonate ion. So the volume which is required to utilize the volume which is required to completely utilize bicarbonate ion is the same volume is required earlier. Means if this is a YML, capital YML, earlier we also required a capital YML for the carbonate ion. So this Y plus Y, how much for the carbonate ion we require a 2 YML N by 10 HCl. That's why we did the 2 times of Y and for the in case of the carbonate ions. And as the overall reaction indicates, the carbonate ions requires 2H positive, means 2 volume of acid to become completely neutralized. That's why we did it 2 times of 2 times of Y, that is 2Y. Now, what is the volume for required for the hydroxyl ion? Simply see the phenolphthalein indicator. For the phenolphthalein indicator, the volume of HCl required is X. From this, the carbonate required capital YML. So the remaining is for the hydroxyl ion, that is X minus Y. So, X minus capital Y is for the hydroxyl ion. The remaining part of the HCl is for a hydroxyl ion for the phenolphthalein indicator. That is X minus Y N by 10 HCl. So, volume of N by 10 HCl is again the hydroxyl ion, that is the X minus Y. Okay, now we move to the calculation part. See, in the calculation, the formula to calculate the strength is normality multiplied by equivalent weight. The normality is not given of the unknown sample solution. First of all, we have to calculate the normality. We calculate the normality with the help of the normality equation. That is simply an N1U1 is equal to N2V. So this is the normality equation with the help of which we calculate the normality of the unknown sample solution. See, this is for unknown, this is for unknown. Unknown normality is not given, that's why we put N. And volume of unknown which we took in our conical flask, that is 10. Known is N by 10 HCl, and that is capital 2Y ml for a carbonate ion. Normality is 1 by 10. Volume is 2Y. Normality of unknown is 2Y divided by 100. And we put actual value instead of this. The concordant reading for the carbonate ion is 8 ml. We can put 8 instead of 2y divided by 100. Now the formula of the strength is strength of carbonate ion is normality multiplied by equivalent weight of carbonate ion. Normality is 8 by 100 multiplied by equivalent weight of carbonate is 30. The equivalent weight is calculated by the formula molecular mass upon upon valency. That is 30. And after calculating this, the answer is 2.4 gram per liter. Is the strength of the carbonate ion. Now we move to the second part of the calculation, that is for the hydroxyl ion. We have to do the same job. First of all, we have to calculate the normality. We again calculate the normality with the help of the normality equation. That is N1V1 is equal to N2V2 dash dash dash, because we earlier used the N1V1 is equal to N2V2. So that in this case we have to apply a dash dash dash. Unknown is, the normality is not given. Volume, which would be in the conical flask, that is 10 ml. Now the known for this hydroxyl ion is again the same N by 10 HCl. But the volume of the N by 10 HCl is different. That is X minus Y ml, capital Y ml for the hydroxyl ion. So put this. Normality is X minus Y divided by 100. We can put the actual reading. That is, the concordant reading for the hydroxyl ion is 2.8 ml divided by 100. Okay. So the strength of the hydroxyl ion normality multiplied by equivalent weight. Normality is 2.8, and you have to multiply the equivalent weight of hydroxyl ion with the normality. Equivalent weight of the hydroxyl ion is 17. Okay, and the strength is after calculating 0.476 gram per liter. So the strength of carbonate and hydroxyl ions are calculated separately. This is the object of the today's experiment, and the result is the strength of the carbonate ion is this and the strength of hydroxyl ion is this. Thank you.